Hello, my beautiful internet friends, and welcome back. Today, we are gonna be talking about this individual. She looks plucky and hopeful and spunky and yeah, well, I have a lot of feelings about the individual in this particular photo, and let's talk about it. I've spent all afternoon going through old photos, and these are all photos that were taken when I lived in Indiana. Now, that used to be like the golden time in my life. There was one year, it was actually I think a little bit less than a year, that I lived in Indiana when I was going to school at Taylor University, and I was 18 and 19, and it was like the first time I ever lived away from home, and I was going to school and things were complicated and difficult and I was figuring stuff out. And how do you like go to class, have a social life, and get laundry done? I never actually figured that out, but it was beautiful and I built a family there and it was amazing. And so these are all photos from that time in my life. And that time in my life is so contrasted with what came right after. And we're gonna talk about how I viewed the merging of those two versions of myself and how I see it now. So let's talk a little bit about love and self-compassion and self-blame. I don't know about you, but that sounds like a fun time to me. Let's dive in. So quick word of warning, we are gonna be talking a little bit about trauma. We're gonna talk a little bit about abusive relationships and sexual assault, but nothing in detail. So if that's something that concerns you or triggers you, I'm gonna link a video of adorable German Shepherd puppies down below. Just follow that link instead of watching this video. Now, I lived in Indiana in 2009 to 2010. And then I came back home because I was having issues with my ankle. I was in a lot of pain, I could barely walk, there were just a lot of problems, and there were issues with funding at my school, and so I had to come home. Coming home from that place was like one of the most devastating blows of my life. I loved it there. I built a home there. I built a family, and I felt love like I never felt loved by people in my life in Indiana. And I came home and I was so lost, I was so alone. I was always like a super people-pleasing person when I was younger. I never really let people in, I never really let them know me. But even still, I felt like people found their way in Indiana. But back in Colorado, it felt like a wasteland, right? I didn't know who I was, I didn't know what I was doing. It felt like the mat was ripped out from underneath me. And I started going to a house church run by a family that was as close as my biological family. Here's where the story actually takes a dark turn. I met a gentleman there who was 7 years my senior. He was serving in a capacity as sort of a pastor. He was a leader at the church. He was really charismatic and he knew exactly what I needed. He knew that I was super lonely. He knew that I never let people in. He knew what I needed to hear and he said it. And we kind of started a relationship that was on and off for 11 months, and he was extraordinarily abusive, but I didn't see it. I sincerely did not see it for 11 months. Anything that ever happened, I just slapped a label on that box of, you know, he's a work in progress, like we're told to forgive people, and that's really fine that he, you know, crossed those boundaries with me, or he did something that I said no to and he went, you know, continued anyways, you know, because he's a broken man and he's trying and blah, 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 like all of this just spiritually manipulative crap that he fed me that I had digested and I had heard most of my life in other regards too, and I did not have the knowledge or the understanding or the willingness to see what was happening. So for 11 months, abuse escalated until in October of 2011. Still freaking hate October. For all of you Halloween nuts out there, I'm really sorry. I can't stand it. I hate it. At the end of October, I was sexually assaulted again by him. This wasn't the first time it happened, but something about that morning, the circumstances were finally clear enough that I saw what was happening. I saw what a dangerous person he was, and I was able to surprisingly safely exit that relationship. Those 11 months, and specifically the end of it, changed me forever, without a shadow of a doubt. I was no longer the Jordan that I was before. I legitimately considered getting a tattoo of a gravestone on me in the months after with like RIP, you know, my name and that date that it happened, because I can't put into words how much that person, the person who was before, to me, had died, was gone, was murdered. But I was like forced to still be alive. It was like being reborn into a world that I never wanted to be a part of. My eyes were opened to so much darkness, to so much pain. I was dealing with PTSD and depression and panic attacks, and I was a mess. And the biggest thing that set in, more than anything else, more than anger over what happened, I hated me. I hated myself. I absolutely despised the person I was for letting this happen. All of the qualities, which I actually do believe are beautiful qualities, that in my mind had contributed to this abuse, I tried to kill in myself, and any memory that reminded me that they existed in me, I just wanted to hulk out and ruin. Like the fact that I was the most trusting person that I knew. I believed the absolute best in everybody. I was so very trusting. I was so very forgiving. I was really innocent. I was just like, I was a really great person, okay? I was really nice. And I hated every single positive quality because that person who had abused me manipulated all of those, had used those to hurt me. And I saw that as my fault, when in reality, that was his fault. He's responsible for his own actions. And during those first few months, and I'll be honest with you, the first few years, when I saw photos of this person, of this girl, I wanted to scream. I wanted to kill her. I felt so much hatred. And I'm actually struggling to like find word for how much negative emotion I directed towards specifically these photos. Because this was before. There was a before Joe and there was an after Joe. And this was the before Joe who had contributed to it in my mind. And in these photos I saw like innocence and everything, but I think the biggest thing that I saw was hope. I saw like hope in me for a better life. I saw faith because I was such a Christian person at this time. I believed so strongly in God. I had a really strong faith and I hated that in these photos. I hated remembering who I used to be because that person existed without knowing how dark the world could be. I think I really hated her happiness because I couldn't feel that anymore. I hated that joy because that was gone and it used to be there and I could see it. Like I could almost touch it in these photos, but it was absolutely disappeared. And so I saw these pictures and I wanted to burn them. I wanted to erase the memory of that person because it was so painful to think about because I no longer existed in that world. And in recent years, as I have gone through years of therapy, go to therapy if you can, guys, it's fantastic. At least it has been for me. I've worked through a lot of the self-blame. I've worked through a lot of the self-hatred. But one thing that has taken a really long time to let go was this feeling that I would ever be okay. I would ever be all right with myself. I would ever actually have hope for the future or feel positive things about looking forward. And these photos were such a reminder of hopes that had been dashed, honestly. And I can remember so many instances of sitting in my townhouse all alone, feeling like this feeling would never end, feeling like this darkness that was so encompassing. Like there was no way I could picture a life without any of it. I could not look forward at the future. Like I didn't have a future in my mind. It was just trying to breathe until the end of the day. Having a happy relationship was a ridiculous proposition. Having a healthy relationship was a ridiculous proposition. Having things I actually found joy in or moments of the day where I didn't think about or I wasn't aware of the trauma that I had experienced felt like it was completely impossible. But I'm sitting here almost 9 years past everything that happened. And now when I look through these photos, I can finally feel compassion for this person. I finally feel a lot of love for her. I look at these pictures now and I'm happy that she was happy. I'm glad for her joy. I don't resent that anymore because I've felt it again. And I think the biggest lesson for me and the biggest reminder and something that I come back to often is I know how positive I used to be looking at photos like this, that I would never feel okay, that I would never actually feel hopeful, that I would never be all right, even for a single freaking second. I was so sure of that. Like if you're in that kind of a position right now, let me just assure you that I was like 100% sure that I would never be okay again. There wasn't a question in my mind, right? And I was so wrong, because I am now really, really happily married to a really good guy. We have a really healthy relationship where we work through things. We live in a house where I feel safe. We have 3 amazing dogs. We have a bunch of puppies and kitties and rats that run around that bring me a lot of joy. And life is difficult still. Mental health is challenging still, but I absolutely do have hope. I absolutely can look towards the future and picture good things for myself. And I'm so glad that I stuck around, that I didn't listen to all those feelings of darkness, whispering that I didn't have a future, because things do feel different now. And going through all of these photos this afternoon, it's cool to me to see the person that I used to be. I'm definitely not her. Like I'm not this girl in the, by the way, this was a cemetery. I'm not this girl in the cemetery anymore trying to look cool in my overly patterned dress, which by the way, I wish I still had it. It's pretty cute, isn't it? Like I'm not her anymore, but I love who I used to be and I can feel at least compassion and understanding for where she was and love for who I used to be instead of just hatred and blame. It's taken a long time to work through a lot of those feelings. It's taken a long time to realize that what happened wasn't caused by me, wasn't my fault, wasn't because I was a nice person. It was because someone else wasn't a nice person. But I wanted to share this with you guys today because going through these photos is such a good reminder to me that we can be so sure of something and so wrong. I knew that I didn't have hope or a future, but I was very wrong. I knew that I would never, ever, ever, ever be okay. I would never have a moment of breathing without the darkness. And I was so wrong, because I do have those moments. And I was pretty darn certain that I would hate her for frickin' ever, and I don't. So if you're in the middle of something where you just feel like you are absolutely drowning, or the darkness will never end, or you cannot picture a way out, I get it. I really do. And you're not wrong for feeling that way. It lasted for a bit for me. Like, there was a lot of fighting that had to happen. There was a lot of holding on, even though there was like nothing to hold on to, and just going to bed and waking up and trying to make it to the end of another day still breathing. But I did it, and I'm here, and life is so different than what I ever pictured it could be, in actually a much better way than I ever could have pictured it, even though there's still stuff. There's always still stuff. Life is still good, and I'm really grateful for it. I guess what I'm saying is, if you're struggling, please hold on. Please know that we can be so sure of something when our minds lie to us. My therapist says we can't believe everything we think, and I think that's so true. So hang in there, take care of yourselves, you're worth it. Thanks for listening, guys. I so appreciate it. It is a great honor of my life to be able to share my story with you guys and be able to hear yours and talk in the comment section. So let me know in the comment section if you've ever felt this way, if you've ever been so sure of something and yet so wrong. I'd love to hear your story down below. Thank you to all of my patrons. You guys keep this channel alive, you keep my puppies fed, and you keep the lights on in this house. You really help. And to everyone watching, thank you. I love you guys. I'm thinking of you, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys. Have heard from the sky.